Ukraine's president has delivered a defiant tribute to his soldiers as the nation marks a sombre milestone in its fight against Russia's invasion. 500 days since the war began, Volodymyr Zelensky appeared in a video from Snake Island, promising that his country will emerge victorious. Our US correspondent Catherine Firkin has the story.
Snake Island has been a symbol of Ukraine's resistance since the early days of Russia's invasion. The small plot of land, the site of that viral video, when Ukrainian soldiers resisted demands to surrender to Moscow forces. Today, President Volodymyr Zelensky posted an equally defiant tribute to his troops, saying, I want to thank from this place of victory each of our soldiers for these 500 days. It's a somber milestone and one neither nation would have hoped to mark as the war drags on. In the latest attack, at least 8 civilians died when their residential neighbourhood in the eastern city of Lyman was targeted in a rocket strike. Russia again accused of using cluster munitions, controversial bombs that explode like fireworks and have a track record of harming civilians, especially children. Their use makes more sense against Russian forces in the forests, the open areas, says Dmytro Chubenko from Ukraine's prosecutor's office. His team has been collecting evidence of Russia's use of the weapons as proof of attacks against civilians. But with Ukraine set to be handed thousands of these controversial bombs themselves from the US, international outrage is growing.
The UK is signatory to a convention which prohibits the production or use of cluster munitions and discourages their use.
Britain, one of at least 120 nations that have banned the bombs, agreeing not to use, produce or stockpile the weapons.
It took me a while to be convinced to do it. But the main thing is they either have the weapon to stop the Russians now or they don't.
On the eve of the NATO summit in Lithuania, President Joe Biden is being forced to defend his decision to send the bombs as part of the latest US military package, a sign of America's ongoing support for Ukraine, but perhaps also an admission that the bloodshed is set to get worse with no resolution in sight. Catherine Firkin for 10 News First, New York.